Hi and welcome you all. Since childhood, we have heard our parents lure us into drinking milk by saying that we could grow stronger and taller if we drink milk. And we have obliged hearing these words, isn't it? So by now, I'm sure you have recognized what that magical component or ingredient in the milk is, which helps us grow stronger or stay stronger and taller or to get taller, and that is the calcium. Now, calcium has many functions in the body apart from preserving our bone health or helping with the nails or with the hair. When I think of calcium, the first thing that occurs to my mind is the conductivity, the nerve conductivity. Now, our muscles function in the body only from the command of the nervous system. The nervous system commands the muscles to function, right? So this is through signals. So it is like electric current passing through our body. The same way the signals are passed on. And for the transmission of this signal, calcium plays a very important role. And when I say the muscle, including the cardiac muscle, that is the heart muscles, function and transmit the signal and carry on with its proper functioning only because of the presence of calcium. So calcium is very important for our body apart from preserving the bone health. Now, we also know that there is something like an alkalinity. We always say that that food is acidic, you're not supposed to take that, or you need to maintain the alkalinity of the blood. Now, the blood, the pH of the blood, when we say it is alkaline, it is at 7.4, and this has to be maintained for the proper functioning, healthy functioning of an individual. If this pH drops below 7, it is detrimental to health. There can be some immediate effects, there can also be long-standing effects, including the formation of certain diseases like cancer is related to, and osteoporosis to a very large extent is because of this acidic pH or the acidity in our blood. Now, calcium helps to curb this acidity. Whenever there is, the body tends to get into this acidic mode, it is a calcium which comes to our rescue. Of course, there are mechanisms in our body which brings about this, including taking the calcium or leaching out the calcium from the bones to be able to maintain the proper pH or the healthy pH of the blood, alkaline pH, that is what is healthy. So, and we also know that we are asked to take some supplementation, especially women are more affected with the deficiency of calcium, and we also land into deficiency because of the hormones in our body and some of the physiological functions or the physiological changes that we have in respect to the men. So we do have menstruation, we do have childbirth, lactation, menopause. These are all the various milestones in a woman's life. So when we go through this, because of the hormonal changes, there can be some calcium loss from our body. Regularly during the menstruation, there is an amount of calcium which is lost from our body. And during pregnancy and lactation, that's a different phase. And of course, there is a lot of calcium being utilized, and the body requires a lot of calcium at that time. And at menopause, we are also affected because of the drop of estrogen. When the estrogen levels drop in our body, the calcium, the osteoblasts or the cells which helps in the regeneration of the bone or which helps in the bone growth, that is reduced and the calcium deposition, the deposited calcium is being leached out, and there tends to be some deficiency or some reduction in the bone mass, what we call the bone density, leading to osteopenia and osteoporosis. We have heard of that. And there again, it is the calcium which plays a very major role. So likewise, when we say there are various functions of this calcium and it goes through, and to regulate this calcium mechanism, we have a gland which is entirely dedicated to it. It is the parathyroid gland. And these glands, there are four glands of this in a normal and regular condition. So these release the hormone parathormone or parathyroid hormone, which is the main function or the only function of these hormones is to only regulate the calcium level in the blood, to see where we need the calcium. So take out the calcium from the bone, supply as required, and stop its production or its synthesis if not required, if we reach a particular level, and so on. So that is the function of the parathyroid gland. So meaning to say, it is such an important mineral which or nutrient which is required by our body for the proper functioning. So the regularly or the in a normal condition, the normal range of calcium that we require is in the blood. When we check the calcium level in the blood, it is around 10 milligrams, 10 milligrams of calcium in the blood. Now, beyond this, like if there is a reduction in this, then all these changes could happen in the body. So, we need to maintain this. And we require on a regular basis, we require around 500 to 600 milligrams of calcium per day, and this has to be supplemented through the food that we eat. And there are situations, as I mentioned, women during pregnancy and lactation and post menopause, we would require larger amount of calcium. It could even go up to 1000 to 1200 milligrams per day, depending on the situation. So then in that case, we need to take the supplements, because no amount of milk, like say if you take 1 or 1.5 liters of milk a day, maybe you would be able to get that. There again, it is the bioavailability. How much of the calcium that we take through this food is available for our bodily functions, that also counts. So that is the reason you would be asked to take some supplementation of calcium. Now, on a regular basis, which are the foods that are help high in calcium? That is, of course, we have already spoken about milk. So milk does have a lot of calcium in it. And apart from that, the fish with small bones, it has calcium in it. Then leafy vegetables, all the leafy vegetables have calcium in it. Some of the nuts and seeds have calcium in it. Same way, some of the grains can supply you with calcium. So there are many food items which could be included. In general, if you include food from all the food groups, the carbohydrates, the proteins and the fat and the micronutrients and the like the vitamins and minerals and the trace elements present in the vegetables and fruits and nuts and seeds, you would be able to get the adequate dose of calcium. But for this calcium to be utilized by the body, we also require vitamin D. So it's very important for us to get this vitamin D as well. So vitamin D, as you know, is through the sun. It's not like the sun is supplying you with vitamin D, but it is the sun rays which, when it falls on our skin, the vitamin D synthesis in the body can take place. So calcium, along with this proper exposure of the sun, will help us get it for the requirement of the body, that is a bioavailable calcium, and thereby stay healthy. So I think I have covered all the functions of the calcium. There might be few which I have left out, but you now know, by now you know how important it is for you to take or include calcium in your diet and in your daily life. So hope it has been helpful. So stay safe and stay healthy. Bye.